Hey guys, it's Chris. A Nigerian billionaire, cocaine hidden in pineapples, and a body found in a suitcase. Here are 10 of the craziest FBI Instagram busts. Number 10, the Nigerian billionaire. Wait a minute, you mean to tell me that the Federal Bureau of Investigation is watching my Instagram stories? I thought I only had to hide my weekend activities from my snoopy parents. But yes, the FBI is in fact all up in our business. Well, when we give them a good reason to be anyways. The Nigerian Instagram star known as Hush Puppy has been busted in a cyber scam worth over $431 million. The man's real name is Raymond Abbas, and he has 2.4 million followers on his social media account. He doesn't do much except show off his lavish lifestyle of wearing designer clothes, driving luxury cars, and flying across the world in private jets. However, he was just busted in Dubai for a crazy scheme in which he ripped off credit card information. His wild posts of him holding money and smiling with all his gold chains caught the attention of government agencies. He was targeting victims overseas by making fake websites. These websites were poor copies of already known companies and banks. So when people put in their credit card information, he was able to steal their money. Raymond passed himself off as an affluent and very wealthy real estate developer. But the truth is, he was just a great big scamming phony. His apartment in Dubai was raided by the FBI and Interpol while he was sound asleep, and they managed to secure $37 million in cash. Who keeps that much cash in their home? The investigators also found about 2 million email addresses from victims stored on phones, computers, and even hard drives. Even though he was busted in Dubai, the Nigerian fake billionaire is still accused of fraud in Europe and the United States. He probably won't be posting to social media again for a very long time. And side note, we think Hush Puppy is kind of a ridiculous name. Number 9. Diamond Thieves. Instagram has managed to help the FBI catch a group of diamond thieves who had committed crimes in at least 10 states across the country. These were smash-and-grab bandits who were terrorizing jewelers. They're currently accused of pulling off over 30 heists. They did this by using sledgehammers to break open the display cases and then run away with the diamonds stuffed into a bag. Not the cleanest criminals, but it was a lucrative scheme. The Fed seized more than $1.5 million in diamonds during their investigation. The members of the gang all came from the city of Detroit, and the only reason that the FBI finally caught up to them is because of social media. It all happened when the federal officers discovered a peculiar Instagram account called Do It for Diamond. It was apparently used by different members of the gang. One of them had posted a picture on the Instagram account wearing a necklace that was stolen from one of the jewelers. It was enough to connect the dots and lead the FBI to the Detroit gang. On June 18th, three of the robbers were arrested while they attempted to break into a jewelry store in Tennessee. Though apparently there were two groups that would drive to the robbery location from Detroit in two separate vehicles. One in a clean car that was either lawfully rented or properly registered, and the other in a burner or stolen vehicle that could be ditched after the robberies. Although some of the men have been caught, the FBI believes there are at least 10 gang members involved, so the case may still be ongoing. Number 8. The Capitol Rioter. The FBI says that they used facial recognition software to track and arrest an individual who took part in the Capitol riots back in 2021. The affidavit was shared online detailing how federal agents discovered the identity of Stephen Chase Randolph using images from the riot. The facial recognition tool identified this guy, then led the FBI to an Instagram page belonging to his girlfriend. To further confirm Randolph's participation, undercover FBI agents went to his workplace on April 13th and approached him. They struck up a casual conversation with Randolph in which he admitted being at the Capitol during the riots, saying, "I was in it, and it was effing fun." But why did the FBI want Randolph so badly? Well, it's because in the videos from the riot, he could be seen assaulting several police officers at the US Capitol, as well as pushing over the barricades, which resulted in an officer hitting her head against the stairs and being knocked unconscious. Federal agents used the girlfriend's Instagram account to get all the information they needed, linking it to Facebook accounts belonging to family members, finding Randolph's full name, and then tracking down where he lived and worked before they made the arrest. Number 7. Drug running. A lot of very stupid drug dealers have been busted selling drugs thanks to their Instagram account. This particular bust happened after the suspected dealer let an undercover agent with the DEA follow him on the social media application. This guy was literally posting pictures of drugs that he had for sale in the Bay Area. He also posted pictures with great big towers of cash that he had made selling these very narcotics. According to the affidavit released by the DEA, they first learned of this guy, real name Marcos Hatch, from a different local man suspected of dealing drugs. In other words, the other guy snitched on Marcos. It was probably one of the easiest investigations ever. The undercover officer requested to follow the dealer on Instagram. He accepted, and the photographs were proof enough for authorities to get a warrant to search his home, where they not only found drugs, but also an AK-47. So on a scale of 1 to 10, Marcos Hatch is how dumb do you think? Let us know your opinions in the comments section down below. And if you're liking this video, be sure to hit the thumbs up and subscribe buttons if you haven't already. Number 6. Fake student. A woman in Florida who happened to be a former police officer was recently arrested after she snuck into a high school and posed as a student to try and collect Instagram followers. This is one of the weirdest cases of the century. Audrey Nicole Franceschini was arrested at 28 years old for sneaking onto the campus of a local high school. She tried to blend in with the students by wearing a backpack and carrying a skateboard as if it was still 1999. She then handed out paper flyers with her Instagram printed on them, asking students to follow her. But then a security guard got suspicious, as she seemed to be harassing the students. The security guard called the police, Audrey ran away, and the police officers then used her own flyers against her, discovering her identity from her Instagram account. She was charged on 3 counts, one for burglary of an occupied dwelling, another for trespassing on an educational institution and interference, and the third for resisting an officer without violence to his person. She racked up $16,500 in fines. And to make this story even weirder, she had actually been charged in 2017 with revenge porn because she stole and posted naked pictures of another officer she had worked with, resulting in her getting fired. As for why she was looking for Instagram followers at a high school, well, we don't really know. And anyway, she's obviously crazy. Number 5. Cocaine pineapples. Have you ever bought a box of pineapples only to realize it was actually a box of cocaine? I mean, I haven't, but maybe you have. Operation Trojan Shield was a huge operation conducted by the FBI to take down criminal groups working across the globe to smuggle drugs and launder money, and it involved hardened encrypted devices. These are devices that transfer messages secretly like an encrypted cell phone. The operation began in 2016 with the FBI investigating a company out of Canada called Phantom Secure, which as it turned out was selling hardened encrypted devices only to criminal organizations. When the police shut down the company, over 10,000 devices being used by these criminals suddenly went dead. The FBI did the same thing with more companies, shutting down all encrypted communication. Basically, the FBI doesn't like people talking if they can't listen in on it. It's because criminals using the devices were organizing crimes under the radar. Crimes like hiding cocaine inside boxes of pineapples. By 2021, Operation Trojan Shield led to the arrest of over 800 people and the seizure of over 8 tons of cocaine and 22 tons of marijuana. Number 4. Russian crypto laundering. The FBI has arrested a Russian rapper residing in the United States for the crime of money laundering. For evidence, the FBI used Instagram pictures in which the rapper incriminated himself by posting huge wads of cash in both dollars and Russian rubles. Maxim Boyko was laundering money in the United States using cryptocurrency as well as conspiring with organized crime syndicates in other parts of the world. He may have continued on with his scam if not for how he entered the States in the first place. He flew into Los Angeles with $20,000 in cash and claimed it was for an investment in Bitcoin. The authorities were skeptical, so they watched him, investigated him, and creeped on his Instagram. They realized he was laundering money and quickly shut Boyko down. What? A guy like this should have known better than to go to the airport with that much cash. Obviously, you'll get flagged for having anything over $10,000. It's a rookie mistake, Boyko. Number 3. Live streaming murder. A man in California did something absolutely horrible. Not only did he murder 2 people, but then live streamed the victims' lifeless corpses. Raymond Michael Weber has since been charged with the murder of 2 women, and the police had all the evidence they needed from a 36-minute long video that he streamed on Instagram. In the live stream, Raymond was holding a firearm, pointing at the dead bodies, and talking about how the women had tricked him and set him up. He also said he was aware that the police were coming soon, and he would never be seen again. The call came in at about 2:45 in the morning, when a woman phoned the police to report someone she thought was armed and dangerous inside an apartment building just outside of Sacramento. She said that the man was live streaming himself on social media inside his apartment. By this time, the two women were already dead. When officers arrived, the man had barricaded himself inside. Raymond would not come out. Cops were forced to burst their way into the apartment, taser the guy, and then arrest him. As for the identity of the two dead women, the police have not yet released anything. According to Fox News, Raymond was a local resident and already wanted on several felonies, including domestic battery and assault with a deadly weapon. Number 2. Dead in a suitcase. A man has been arrested in connection to a dead Instagram influencer who was discovered deceased and stuffed into a suitcase. This is some seriously graphic stuff, so be prepared. Instagram influencer Ekaterina Karaglanova, only 24 years old, was stabbed multiple times and then put into a suitcase and left inside her Moscow apartment. So who found her body? Sadly, it was her parents. They let themselves into her apartment after she neglected to answer their calls for almost a week. They found her brutalized inside the suitcase, and afterward the authorities were quick to arrest a man in connection with the killing. A man who was apparently jealous of the young and attractive Instagram star's lifestyle, her travel plans, and her new boyfriend. She had about 85,000 Instagram followers, making lots of money from sharing photos of herself in lingerie and at luxury hotels. But all that luxury ended up being her downfall, as the jealous man decided that she just didn't deserve it. Number 1. Bitcoin scam. A popular personality on Instagram known as Jay Mazzani has been charged with wire fraud. His real name is Jabara Igbara, and he used his popularity on social media to trick his followers into selling him Bitcoin. This guy actually had people who liked him enough to follow him on social media send him Bitcoin while saying that he was going to send wire transfers to them, paying up to 5% above market value. But in reality, he never sent any money to anyone and ended up getting away with $2.5 million in Bitcoin from his victims. But he didn't get away for long, since he was busted by the FBI after his victims freaked out and the internet exploded in complaints. You can't have a million followers on Instagram and rip off that many people without somebody taking notice. However, even though Jay was busted by the FBI, he still hasn't technically been charged. The investigation is still ongoing, with the good news being that if he is found guilty, he could face up to 20 years in prison. And that'll probably make the people he ripped off feel a whole lot better about the situation. But hey, this is why you don't send strangers on the internet money. It's only a scam if you fall for it. Thanks for watching. How do you feel about the FBI busting criminals on Instagram? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. And if you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit the subscribe button for more. We'll see you next time.